Welcome to the unit overview for Math 1, Unit 3, Features of Functions. In this unit, we will be using everyday scenarios to develop an understanding of what a function is, how functions can be used, and the appropriate notation for functions. Jeff White once said, "If math is such an important subject, and it is, why teach it in a way that is dependent on a child's weakest mental ability, memory, rather than her strongest mental ability, imagination." This quote is very fitting based on the design of this unit because it starts with a couple scenarios that you'll hopefully find interesting and be able to relate to: a pool party and rafting down a river. From those scenarios and the power of our imagination and critical thinking, we will draw out the definition of a function and how to use functions to model the world around us. The big ideas for this unit include looking at the key features of functions: domain, range, intervals where the function is increasing or decreasing, positive or negative, x and y intercepts, maximums or minimums, and interpreting what these values mean in the context of real-world situations. We will also be looking at function notation. You have actually written functions and function notation already in this course, but in this unit we will be clarifying the difference between inputs and outputs and their respective roles within function notation. Here's an example of a function with most of its key features labeled or described. You can see the domain, range, and intervals where the function is increasing or decreasing labeled to the side of the graph. You can also see that this is an example of a continuous function. Other key features are labeled on the graph itself. At this point, you may not understand how to determine these key features, but you can begin to think about what these terms mean. In units 1 and 2, you wrote functions and function notation, but now we will dig deeper into understanding the concept of inputs and outputs and how they relate to the context of a function. Here's a list of key vocabulary terms for this unit. Some of these vocabulary terms should already be familiar to you, such as slope and rate of change. By the end of this unit, you will be fluent with all these terms. Entering this unit, you should feel confident with the following skills from previous math courses and previous units in this course so far. You should be able to interpret the features of a graph in context, create a graph given a set of data, find the slope and rate of change from a graph or function rule, simplify linear and exponential expressions, and model relationships with linear and exponential functions. In addition to your teacher and school-based resources, there are several additional resources available to support you in this unit. The Ready, Set, Go homework help videos are housed in the Canvas site for your class. You can access these in Canvas using your student login. If you do not know how to log in to Canvas, ask your teacher for help. The K-12 Math Resources website, which can be found on your school's website, includes additional support items, such as unit and lesson overviews, videos overviewing the tasks, essential vocabulary, the North Carolina standards for each unit, learning targets for each lesson, and extra practice problems. Thank you for watching, and I really hope you enjoyed this unit.